Thank you very much. Thank you for this chance to speak, and I would like to thank all the participants who are with us today. My goal today is not to speak about pros and contras of surgery or drug treatment, but I would rather speak about the innovations in the drug treatment of the ovaries cancer relapses. I'm an oncogynecologist and not a therapist, but I believe that we should be familiar with all the innovations in the field, and I would like to touch upon this event of 2020 in May this year. Finally, we received the results of this study mentioned by Professor Zejula. AGO Desktop 3, we expected the results for overall survival. ASCO 2020, interesting Chinese study was presented, trial with a focus on surgery. We know 213 American trial presented by Coleman last year. The primary point there was not the surgical method in the treatment of relapses of ovaries cancer, but the drug treatment, anti-angiogenic treatment. Only trial 213 demonstrated worse results without the progressive survival where surgery was used, and overall survival rate was not that reliable there. We can see the results of survival of a big European trial in which Professor Zejula was involved, and we're very happy that he's with us today, and we were able to listen to the results of this particular trial from him that demonstrated the overall gain of 53 against 46 with the surgical intervention with the platinum-sensitive ovaries cancer. Well, of course, within a short period of time, it was very difficult to cover all of that. We hope that there will be a time when Professor Zejula arrives here, and then we will be able to speak in much more detail on the results of the trial. Yes, there are details, and the selection of patients for surgery and compliance matters are very important, and the level of the optimal debulking. The best results observed in the surgical protocols, and it's 76% and 84% in GOG. There are certain advances with the drug therapy in the treatment of the ovaries cancer relapses. You can see in the American trial that androgenic drugs were used four times more often, and inhibitors were probably not used. We do not know. They were not recorded, but they were definitely used, we believe, and they could have an impact on the results. As for anti-androgenic drugs, now the results were published at Greater Oceans and really demonstrated among the platinum-resistant and platinum-sensitive relapses, the gain was quite high with the chemotherapeutic treatment. Anti-androgenic drug, bemcentinib, so GOG already mentioned. This was demonstrated with the increase of overall survival. If the platinum chemotherapy is used and anti-androgenic drugs. Now, since in the primary treatment of the ovaries cancer, quite often bevacizumab is used, we wonder if bevacizumab can be used again during the relapses. METO16 trial tried to answer the question in 2018. Professor Pignata was involved in that. He compared two arms and with bosentan used and not used during the first line of therapy. And without the progressive survival, the cane was where bosentan was administered, and overall survival, the trend was better in this group, but without statistical reliability. So the important the impact of bemiparin is quite there. And we must remember also the toxicity profile, hypertension, that's quite typical of angiogenic drugs. So this works quite well for the relapses in ovarian cancer, but can it be used to other drugs? Maybe it might improve the efficacy of other drugs, inhibitors, for example, niraparib and bevacizumab was assessed in parallel. Now, we know that NIPAR inhibitors are quite often used nowadays in the trial 19 and in the NOVA trial and Ariel Rugaparib, where the best effect was among the BRCA positive patients, and Rugaparib, and the group of BRCA non positive, and there was a certain gain from PAR inhibitors. So the United States approved this particular drug. And now we were able to obtain fresh results for SOLO2 results in tablets and pills for relapsed ovarian cancer. We were able to get similar results, similar to trial 19. The drug is quite effective with the relapses.
PARP inhibitors work in case of a relapse of ovarian cancer, and in case of primary ovarian cancer, PARP inhibitors are used. And we would like to improve the results of treatment aiding adding endogenic medications to PARP inhibitors. It was an attempt. The European team Quadra, the second phase of clinical trial, they demonstrated effectiveness of niraparib with the severe non-naive ovarian cancers. It was a relapse. It was impossible to administer platinum treatment, and patients were administered niraparib. The results turned out to be promising. This trial devoted to combined treatment, niraparib with the nivolumab, PARP inhibitors plus angiogenic medication in treatment of a platinum-sensitive ovarian relapse cancer. It was a combined treatment. As to the toxicity profile, we can see the main complications such as hypertension, and it's typical of endogenic medications, but for the quality of life, the results are quite satisfactory. It was summarized that this trial, this first randomized clinical trial, it was reported in ESMA 19, bevacizumab can be used in case of a relapsed ovarian cancer without use of the traditional chemotherapy in case of non-naive, severe treated patients. Good results were achieved in case of the progression-free survival. But there are some specific features. It's the second phase clinical trial. We would like The clinical trial, the third phase, has been planned, AVATAR, to compare this regimen, comparing two standardized therapeutic regimen in case of a relapsed ovarian cancer. Angiogenic medication can be combined with the PARP inhibitors regimen. It will improve the survival rate of relapsed ovarian cancer patients. In case of the use of other angiogenic medications, the tyrosine kinase inhibitors, selective inhibitors of the receptors of the first, second, and third endothelium or growth factor, they showed the effectiveness in case of the progression-free survival. But unfortunately, the third phase that was reported the previous month on ASCO 2020, the use of olaparib or olaparib plus itzidilimab as addition to a standardized therapeutic treatment. You can see three arms. The slide demonstrates the design of the third phase trial: olaparib, cediranib, and platinum-based chemotherapy. Unfortunately, as to the results of progression-free survival, we didn't achieve a better effect in case of a combined treatment. As to progression-free survival of median 10, 10, and 8 months, as to the overall survival results, we had 31, 30, and 29 months. No great success, so that the standardized platinum-containing chemotherapy is still a standard. As to the platinum-resistant ovarian cancer, it's quite complicated. On ESMO 19, the results were reported as to the negative results in case of the platinum-resistant cancer form, Barocta, where cediranib, olaparib were used against paclitaxel. The results were not promising. It's quite difficult to decide in case of the immunotherapy, in case of the ovarian cancer. Results of the clinical trial KEYNOTE-100 was announced that was quite successful in case of the cervical cancer and the endometrial cancer. The results will be reported during the next sections as to the use of pembrolizumab in oncotherapy. But unfortunately, in case of ovarian cancer, pembrolizumab demonstrated moderate anti-tumor activity during the 37-month follow-up. The overall response was 8.5%, the duration of the response 10 months. There were quite a great number of clear cell tumors, and the overall survival in the case of clear cell tumors were 21%. Summarizing all the points that I tried to cover briefly, in case of some novelties in the therapeutic treatment of the relapsed ovarian cancer, and the standardized standards are the systemic chemotherapy targeted medications. They are effective in case of the maintenance angiogenic medications, PARPs inhibitors, target medications. They are still under consideration. Immunotherapy, we have been studied immunotherapy up to the time being.